industry and the government also owe to the HRAO for focusing on tourism and also to promote Odisha at their own capacity in the country and outside the country. I think we'll have to acknowledge the work, good work done by J.K. Mahanti and the entire team of HRAO for a number of years and ably supplemented by Tourism Department and the government of Odisha. Odisha's tourism industry has actually not changed much over a period of time. I was tourism secretary about 2 decades ago, and I was seeing the figures of arrivals. It has not changed much. We all know that Odisha has huge potentials, but for some reason it has not translated into the kind of activity that we deserve. In fact, I'm somebody who is very strongly committed to domestic tourism. I would not like to distinguish between a domestic and a foreign tourist. As long as the tourist pays money to stay in a hotel, the hotel industry grows, he hires a taxi, the travel industry grows. So the domestic tourist also spend the same kind of money. In fact, I'm told some of the regions in the country, like from Punjab or Gujarat, those travelers spend more money in the hotel in ordering food than the foreign travelers do. But anyway, that is a small part of it. So domestic industry also is growing hugely. And since the average domestic traveler has already seen Rajasthan and Kerala and Goa, today he is going out of the country. The Indians are next to Chinese now in spending money outside India. A huge amount of money is being spent by Indians in destinations like Dubai, in Thailand, Southeast Asia. Now they are traveling even to farther US, Europe, Alaska, all kinds of places they are traveling. Why are they traveling in such large numbers? Obviously, we cannot prevent, they should travel outside. But are Indians traveling at the cost of Indian destinations? I think yes. If some of the other destinations in India, like Odisha, maybe even Andhra Pradesh or Tamil Nadu, were as friendly and as welcoming and had all the amenities like Goa or Kerala or Rajasthan, then probably some of these travelers who are traveling outside probably would be spending that money in the country. So the challenge is to upgrade our own tourism products and make it attractive to the domestic travelers also. Foreign travelers will definitely come, but domestic travelers, the middle class in India, as we all know, is growing. They have now big capacity to spend. And India is such a huge country with so much of diversity that we deserve to do better, even domestically. Now, Vishal mentioned about few challenges. I also completely agree that not having good hotels in Odisha is the foremost challenge. What has not changed in Odisha is the number of hotels and number of rooms. I was looking at the presentation made by HRAO. The number of rooms in the star categories in Odisha has the least growth in the country. And the number of hotels under constructions also in Odisha have the least growth compared to other destinations. Now you can promote, you can market, you can spend money in televisions and media. That is the easiest part of the work. You can hire a good consultant, a smart consultant, he's going to brand you, market you aggressively. The point is, if you don't hotels, where are they going to stay? Whatever the government can do is a supplementary activity, in my view. If an investor has invested in a hotel, the amount of focus and aggression that he is going to bring to market his own property, government can never match that. A hotelier who has invested his hard-earned money in a hotel, or a number of hoteliers have invested money in a destination, their focus and their approach is definitely going to be much more professional, definitely going to be much more aggressive, and they are going to be dynamic. The government can only supplement that effort. Government's money will definitely go towards helping their cause. The fact of the matter in Odisha, and when I say that, I hope people don't mind, that the local enterprise in Odisha is pretty shallow. There is not much depth in local enterprise. I always give this example. We have this Chilika Lake, which is about 1,000 square kilometer, and we have only one good hotel now, which is J.K. Mahanti's hotel, and we have two or three tourism properties. And it has not changed. It has been this way until this new hotel has come from Swasti for about 4 to 5 decades. So the local enterprise, which is also growing, has to respond to these challenges, and they have to build hotels. Oh, they have some challenges in finding land. I know, I acknowledge, with the coastal regulation zone and the environment laws are getting stiffer, stronger. It is a challenge to find law. I know from Puri to Konarak, the beautiful Marine Drive has no hotels today because the hoteliers can't buy land. Almost everything is categorized as forest or environmentally sensitive or ecologically sensitive. So the challenge for the state government now is to, as Vishal was telling, to get land and provide that land in a transparent manner and fast. The point is, government doesn't move fast. We have lost a lot of time in not allotting the Samuka land, which has been identified, acquired for last 2 decades. So we have to move fast. There is no time to lose. We need to upgrade our destination. Puri is a very, very big domestic destination. Now, no Calcutta person think about his holiday without Puri. He has to come to Puri. But we want to upgrade. We want to build a good international class tourism area, which is Shamuka, with good star category hotel, where the tourists are going to spend money, stay, have experience, and spend money. We want to upgrade, but then we have not moved fast. We need to now move fast. We have challenges. We have to find land for our hoteliers, both local as well as outsiders. There is nothing called outsider now. We have welcomed everybody from outside the state, even from international investors. We need to upgrade our hotel. That is the foremost challenge. Other challenges, as Mr. Mahanti has mentioned about, the building plan clearances, the fire challenges. As you know, the government is seized with this matter. We are working on this. I think something will come out. But then the requirement of the industry also is to comply to the building plan. Unless you have a building plan compliance, you may not get fire license. And without fire licenses, you cannot get star categorization. But then anyway, the old hotels have genuine problems, and we will find some ways regarding that. Other areas in which I think there is an issue in Orissa, our beaches, our public area today has no ownership. We have to create a system that the beach has owners and our public area doesn't have trash. Those who benefit from the beach, those who benefit from the public area, the parks, the ecological areas, must have some kind of a system of ownership so that they spend money and clean it. You can go to these interior areas on a picnic, the day after the picnic, and you can see how much trash is collected. It is a very silly subject to discuss, but this is a very, very real problem. We do not have enough toilets on the road. Imagine an ordinary traveler who is traveling. Somebody was mentioning to us that if he is traveling from the Andhra side and he enters into the Orissa area, there is no toilet on the road. In Andhra, you have restaurants and hotels and bars. People can go and use the toilet. What about Orissa? I think there is almost nothing on the road from the Jamsola to Bhubaneswar. So we have to have toilets, PPP mode, or encourage the government or the private owners to develop restaurant complexes with toilets. These are small things, but these are going to go a long way.